little poop.
Well, Cleveland, you're going to have quite a doozy of a choice to make. On the one hand, you have a politician who's running for the Senate, a congressman, who's been pretty good at advocating for the constituency that he represents. And then you have an author who, well, was a Silicon Valley protege of Peter Thiel. And if you don't know who Peter Thiel is, he's an uber wealthy individual who's very much a racist, and I would say borderline semi-fascist. And basically, this author, J.D. Vance, is running for an open seat, the Senate in Ohio. And well, I'm not sure if this is a good analogy or not, but he's sort of kind of like a nasty East Coast hot dog that you have to put a lot of condiments on to catch up with Dijon mustard, the relish. You need chili. You need pico de gallo. Don't forget the sauerkraut. You have to put all of those condiments on this nasty tasting East Coast hot dog to mask the taste of the actual hot dog that you're consuming. That's J.D. Vance in a nutshell. He's had every surrogate you can think of come to Ohio and campaign with him. The lunatic from Mar-a-Lago was there tonight in Toledo. Marjorie Taylor Greene was there about a week ago. Ted Cruz flies there more than he does Cancun. Why does J.D. Vance have to have so many people campaigning for him in Ohio? Well, the simple question or answer to that is that, well, people realize he's like a nasty East Coast hot dog with a lot of condiments. You know, you gotta think about it like this. Who's gonna codify Roe? Is it gonna be Tim or JD? It's certainly not gonna be JD. And I tell you why. He's way out on a limb, so to speak. He's pretty fringe. Now you say, aren't most of the Republican candidates this year running fringe? Yes, that's true. But J.D. Vance not only wants to tell women what they can do in their OBGYN office, he also wants to tell them what they can do legally through the court system, too. I'm paraphrasing, but I kid you not, folks. This is what J.D. Vance said. He recently said that he doesn't think that it's productive in our society to allow women to be able to divorce, even if they're going through domestic violence and domestic abuse. So, I give you an example. Say, for instance, you're married to a fella by the name of Herschel Walker, who happens to be a senatorial candidate of the Republican Party in Georgia. You're married to Herschel Walker. And one night, Herschel gets his gun. It's loaded. And points it point blank at your forehead and tells you he's going to shoot you. In J.D. Vance's world, for the welfare of the children, you should stay together. Now, I kind of think that's a little fringe. Kind of way out on a limb. But it sort of kind of meshes well with these folks nowadays. They want to completely control women. Every decision. Who they marry. Whether they can divorce. What they do with their reproductive care. Everything. They want to control everything. So you know JD is not going to vote to codify Roe. So if that's something that's important to you, which it is to pretty much everyone. Now, you said everybody's not in support of Roe, of abortion. This is true. Every woman does not support abortion. But what they do support is their reproductive health care. And that choice being left up to each individual woman to make. That's what every woman does support. J.D. Vance does not. So he's not going to codify Roe. And he's going to take your right to divorce away from you. Now you say, wait a minute. That sounds extreme. But you have to remember, in this country, up until 1950 or 70, can't exactly remember the year. Women weren't allowed to divorce. Only the husband was allowed to legally divorce. So, all of these achievements and rights that have been gained can definitely be taken away if you give fringe extremist candidates in office, which they all seem to be gravitating to one political party recently. Now, I didn't watch the rally tonight from the lunatic from Mar-a-Lago. I figured he would rant and rave about the Mar-a-Lago estate being raided, you know. And that story has changed. Just a little bit off topic here. That story has changed a little bit. At first, they were all declassified documents, and he had a right to possess them. Remember, he told you that lie. It's all been declassified, which I was thinking to myself, wait a minute. I know a lot, but I don't know about the extramarital affairs of foreign leaders, which apparently was in some of the documents. Now we hear from his lawyers that it was nothing more than news clippings. Wait a minute. He told us they were declassified documents. Now his lawyers say they're news clippings. See, this is what happens when you're a pathological liar and you cannot keep up with your lies. So I didn't need to watch that whole show production that he was putting on to benefit J.D. Vance, which, if you think about it, really shouldn't even be happening. Here's a state, Ohio, which the lunatic won both times by 8 percentage points. Yet, the Republicans are pouring in $28 million just this week, $28 million into Ohio to pump up J.D. Vance. That's how nasty the hot talk must taste. That they have to load so much money and put so many condiments on the hot dog. But I think that the residents, Cleveland, of Ohio, are going to get one bite of the hot dog and spit it out. And I think they're going to do that before the election day. You know, J.D. Vance is going to have to tell people what he stands for. He comes and attends these big Trump rallies because he doesn't have to really talk very much. But when he's out there with the constituents, Ohioans, he says nothing. Now he's pro-union. But when he was out on the West Coast, he didn't want workers to have unions. Remember, they told all of the tech companies, you don't need unions. We'll take care of you. And sadly enough, a lot of tech employees bought into this idea of not needing unions. And now you see willy-nilly tech companies laying off employees and tech companies saying, wait a minute, maybe we should have unionized. But you know who the forerunner for telling workers in Silicon Valley that unions were evil and that they didn't need unions? It was Peter Thiel and J.D. Vance, his underling. Now, J.D. Vance has taken $14 million from Peter Thiel. So, he needs Donald Trump. He needs Marjorie Taylor Greene, Ted Cruz. He needs Peter Thiel. He needs Mitch McConnell to send him $28 million. You've got to stop and think how terrible of a candidate you must be to need all of this outside support. Usually, when it's on the other side and a candidate is being financed by George Soros, you never hear the end of it. Oh, somebody got $1 million from George Soros. They're bought and paid for by Soros. That's the traditional conservative talking point. J.D. Vance got $14 million from Peter Thiel. Is he not bought and paid for by Peter Thiel? He got $28 million from Mitch McConnell. Is he not bought and paid for by Mitch? He's having rallies done by the lunatic from Mar-a-Lago. Is he not in his pocket? These are all legitimate questions to ask yourself prior to voting. These are really legitimate questions. Because it seems like to me J.D. Vance is trying to weasel his way into a Senate seat. Look, he got kicked out of Silicon Valley. He can't go back there. So he went back to a state that he hasn't been to in forever and says, Ohio is my home. But not really. He's kind of like a carpetbagger. Like the dude in New Jersey that's running in Pennsylvania. Cleveland, this is very important. You're going to have to come out and defend democracy. It's very important. The reason J.D. Vance can't tell you what he wants to do is because it's not going to help drive down inflation. It's not going to solve the migration problem on the southern border. And it's certainly not going to give women their fundamental rights, liberties, and freedoms. No. J.D. Vance has already telegraphed what he and the Republican Party want to do as soon as they win. Investigate Joe Biden. Impeach Joe Biden. That's it. That's the end of the agenda. Beginning and end. You know, recently Cleveland changed their baseball name. It was the Cleveland Indians. And the community, the team, the owners, they said it's time to be more sensitive. Other communities' concerns. It's time to be more equitable and inclusive. So they changed the name from Cleveland Indians, the baseball team, to the Cleveland Guardians. I hope the residents of Cleveland will guard their state against this fringe candidate, J.D. Vance. He's fringe. When you don't want women to be able to divorce when they're going through domestic violence and domestic abuse, that's fringe. Is he going to vote to codify same-sex marriage? No. That's why they're waiting after the election. He figured if they win the Senate, the Republicans, then they'll do a national abortion ban and get rid of same-sex marriage. And then they'll go to divorce. And then they'll go to, marriage in general. You can't marry who you are. You can't divorce. You can't play soccer at the public school because you happen to be transgender. This is the party that used to bill itself as limited government. Now they seem to be the most intrusive. I mean, they have a magnet school watching everything. Divorce. Who you mean? What you do in your OBGYN office? Cleveland, is this really what you want? Because if you want that, the choice is clear. Vote for J.D. Vance. He's going to tell you who you can marry. going to tell you if you're a woman, you have no right to divorce. Only men can divorce. This is the reality that we find ourselves in, Cleveland. It's imperative that we make a very informative choice. Now you have Tim Ryan in the congressman. I love how conservatives are trying to say he's a puppet of Joe Biden and liberals. Really? Tim Ryan, this is a fact. You can look it up. Challenged Nancy Pelosi for the speakership. Tim Ryan has been an outspoken critic of certain elements of Joe Biden's policies, as well as when former President Barack Obama was in office, as well as supporting certain things that the lunatic from Mar-a-Lago wanted to do. So he's really a moderate Democrat, running up against a fringe extremist, MAGA type. Look, if he was running against a moderate Republican, it'd sort of kind of be difficult to win this race. But you had in the Republican primary, think about this too. You almost had a physical fight between an elderly man and someone in politics, in the government. The state attorney general, I believe. Or treasure. They almost went to blows during the Republican debate on the stage. I don't think to this day we know which one of them called each other a pussy. And J.D. Vance sort of kind of just sat back in his chair and smiled. And this is the extent of the Republican Party. And it gets no better in the congressional delegation either. We're going to be in Akron tomorrow. The whole rally. Our first GOTV rally for Amelia Stiles, who's running in Ohio 13. Look. Well, let me be frank. If you want to codify Roe, vote Democrat. If you want to codify same-sex marriage, vote Democrat. If you are concerned that they might take away your right to divorce if you're going through a domestic violence situation, vote Democrat. If you don't want to see the current president impeach while we're going through inflation in our country, vote Democrat. If you're tired of seeing the lunatic from Mar-a-Lago, vote Democrat. It's just that simple, people. Because your alternative is really fringe. It's way out there on a limb. I couldn't believe that he said that women should stay in relationships even if they're suffering domestic violence and domestic abuse, because it's better for the welfare of the children I'm like, wait a minute. What research has J.D. Vance done to make such a bold statement such as this? You want to know how much he's done? Zilch. Nada. Because there's absolutely no research in the world that would back up that statement. If I'm Tim Ryan, I'm hammering J.D. Vance all the time about these fringe, crazy, bonkers philosophical beliefs that he has. You gotta get tough. It's just the nature of the game. You gotta inform the people of how extreme these folks are. They want to control every element. A woman. It's a reality that there are certain people in our society that view women as property of men. They don't belong to themselves. They can't be trusted. And that sentiment, or that philosophical belief, is the dominant and very prevalent ideology of modern-day conservatism at this point in time in our country. Cleveland, you're going to have to turn out like you've never turned out before. You're going to have to show up and show out. And I think you will. I think people know what's at stake. Their very lives, their very existence and comfort, their notion of safety, all of that is at risk. Can you imagine telling women to stay in a domestic violence situation because you suffer from so much toxic masculinity-driven programming that you think that would be best for a woman as opposed to leaving an individual that's clearly deranged? So I guess Herschel Walker's ex-wife should not have divorced him, even though he pointed a loaded gun at her head and then called her family and threatened to kill the entire family and shoot the dogs. I guess she should have stayed. Maybe if she had baked the cake, made a couple of sandwiches, gave him a foot massage, everything would have gone over much better. This is their thinking. It's completely bonkers. It's dangerous. And if you give them control, you put them in power, they will implement this ridiculous bullshit on all of us, regardless of how many of us don't want it. Think about that. The Supreme Court took away a right of the citizenry. A That's never happened before in the history of this country. To give the citizenry a right for 50 years, 5 decades, a half a century, and then say, you know, there was no precedent for it. It's unconstitutional. We're taking your rights away, women. You can't be trusted. And a small word about reproductive care. I would really ask every Republican candidate running in 2022, okay, you say abortion is murder. That's your religious belief. Cool beans. So every woman that's had an abortion is a murderer. You have to follow this insanity to its logical conclusion. I would really press them on that. Because something tells me they're not going to want to go there. They're going to scrub their websites like they're doing. They're going to soften their tone, except for Lindsey Graham. He's got an arbitrary 15-week abortion ban. Now, you know if they take control of the Senate and the House, it'll start at 15, then it'll go down to 8, then it'll go down to 6, then it'll go down to 4, then it'll be 2, and then it'll be 0. That's what happens when you start putting arbitrary numbers on a medical procedure that none of these men, for the most part, have any clue about. Cleveland, please guard your city and your state from MAGA. You're the guardians now. Please don't allow MAGA into your city. Into your state. J.D. Vance is MAGA. And everyone you saw there at that rally tonight is MAGA. They're not making America great. They're making America hate. Guard against the hate, please. I know you can do it.